Lately, I've felt the renewed pull of music of the 18th century and need to spend enough time there to refresh my thirsty soul. The idea of treating this particular composition as my way into that came to me while I was dissecting Mio's Creation, a jazz ballet composed of an overture and five scenes. That formal plan reminded me a little of the 18th century tradition represented by today's offering, the orchestral suite, by which is usually meant a suite of dances. Compositions that fit that category follow an established pattern, generally speaking, a French-style overture followed by dances in repeated two-part forms, including alternations between pairs of dances, minuet and trio style. Suites from different cultures included different dances, of course, but the overall pattern was a useful theme to be varied. The composition, usually known in English as Telemann's Don Quixote Suite, was actually designated a burlesque by the composer, a lighthearted tribute to the Cervantes novel, with a number of scenes represented musically in stylized dance forms bearing descriptive titles. The work was one of Telemann's last, written in 1767, not long before his death. From the sound of it, you probably wouldn't guess it to be the work of a man in his 80s. The overture that opens the work is the kind of overture developed at the court of Louis XIV by Jean-Baptiste Lully. This type of overture was originally meant to be played before the raising of the curtain on the first scene of an opera. Such an overture typically opens in a broad tempo with jagged melodic figures and dotted rhythms, rather pompous sounding usually, since that's the music that accompanied the king's grand strutting entry into the theater. This opening broad-paced section, always repeated, is succeeded by a fast fugal essay, and then some of the slower tempo music returns at the end to round out the whole. Different composers adopted different strategies. In the overtures to Bach's extant orchestral suites, the fast fugal essay and closing slow section are repeated. In Telemann's examples, they usually aren't. In Handel's, the return of the slow music is usually missing altogether. That's one of many ways you can pretty readily distinguish those three contemporaries. Following the overture in the present case, Telemann treats us to a few scenes from the Cervantes novel. A bleary-eyed minuet suggests not only the dawn's physical awakening, but also the dawning of the realization that drove him to deeds of derring do. A furious attack on the windmills that attack right back. His sighing after the hopelessly idealized Dulcinea, depicted by a sweetly exaggerated appoggiatura motive in the melody, the comic mocking of Sancho Panza and his braying mule, the contrasted gait of the two steeds, and Quixote's drifting off to sleep at the very end to the most rustic-sounding music imaginable, musical contentment, if ever there was such. As far as my including this work in my concerto series goes, keep in mind that this post represents a larger project in my field of view, which includes Bach's four orchestral suites. Those are, in a sense, very much like concertos, so I'm being consistent in advance. The recording is by the Orchestra of St. Luke's, led by Michael Feldman. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.